Okay, so these are the minutes of the meeting of the deans of schools and director college for something held at VC's camp office. So it was the members present were Professor Apparao Podile, Professor Vipin Srivastav, Professor VP Sanjay, who is the director of CIS, Professor M. Durga Prasad, the Dean of School of Chemistry, Professor Geeta K. Vemuganti, Dean of School of Medical Sciences, Professor Uma Maheshwar Rao, who is the represented Dean of School of Humanities, Professor P. Reddanna, Dean of School of Life Sciences, Professor B. Kamaya, Dean of School of Economics, Professor K. K. Mishra, Dean of School of Social Sciences, Professor B. Sri Padmavati, Dean of School of Mathematics and Statistics, Professor Rajendra Singh, Dean of School of Physics, Professor P. Ramalinga Shastri, Dean of SN School of Arts and Communication, Professor B. Rajashekhar, Dean School of Management Studies, Professor Arun Agarwal, Dean of School of Computer and Information Sciences, and Professor Ghanshyam Krishna, Dean of School of... Okay. So the following points emerged from the meeting according to the minutes. One, the members noted that the decision to prevent the entry of outsiders and media made on 22nd March 2016 had been useful to maintain normalcy in the campus. On 23rd March 2016, several people from media, politicians, Mr. Kanhaiya Kumar, president of GNUSU, Mrs. Radhika Vemula, etc., were not permitted by the security staff of the university. The members complimented the university security staff and also the external support given by the police in the process. However, the university security needs to keep a constant vigil on the possible sneaking of the media into the campus. The PRO should be notified as and when the media illegally makes its presence on the campus so as to deal with them appropriately. Point 2. It was felt that the facts given by the university to the media had been received with less priority. At the same time, negative and concocted stories were given wide coverage. For example, the incident on 22nd March 2016 involving vandalism and violence perpetrated by a group of students at the VC's camp office has not been reported even minutely in the media. In view of the damaging reports, this is the third point, in view of the damaging reports in media, it was decided that Professor Vipin Srivastav would be appointed as the official spokesperson of the university to present the version of the university on the happenings and also clarify things. He would be supported by Professor Sanjay Subodh.
Department of History, Dr. Vasuki Belavadi SN School and the public relations officer. This team would also provide clarification on any issue.
The contact details like email ID, phone number would also be uploaded on the website.
Other this team, only the VC would speak. Other than this team, only the VC Hello. Should speak to the media on behalf of the university.
This team would immediately
put up a comprehensive note on the incident accompanied by photos and videos of the vandalism and violence that occurred on 22nd March 2016 on the website of the university. The notes or clarification to be put up would also be translated by the Hindi officer for the larger information of the public. Point 4. A complaint was lodged by the university on the violence that broke out on 22nd March 2016. The university is yet to receive an official version of the documents prepared by the police.
It was further noted that the police had given at least 2 hours of time for the violent, agitating students to disperse. Students were requested, counseled, and were even explained the consequences of their involvement in such an act and were asked to leave the place. The police had to take action only after all the methods to evict them were exhausted. It was unfortunate that the students forced police action on their own. The violence that started around 10:40 a.m. when the students jumped over the gates, broke doors, damaged furniture, office computers, personal laptop, etc. continued beyond 4 p.m. and the agitating group did not listen to anybody during this time. Point 5. As per the strategy to be followed by the deans of the day of resumption of classes, that is on 28th March 2016, following suspension of classes from 23rd to 26th March 2016, university security needs to spread at all the schools besides police patrolling. The police will help only when the reported obstruction becomes uncontrollable. This arrangement shall be in place till the end of this semester examination. The university will request the police for necessary assistance during the period. Simultaneously, the security of the university will also be strengthened. Point 6. It was decided that this recruitment of security guards through outsourcing agency would happen strictly based on competency level and gender basis that should withstand harshest security concerns. It was also felt that the university should not hesitate on the expenditure to be incurred on security. The university would soon discuss the requirements with security agencies and also explore the possibility to hire CISF services, Central Industrial Security Forces, on a pilot scale at the earliest. Adequate security cameras, swiping cards for students of multiple utility, installing required gadgets to be done to move towards professional security system, at least for the places of vulnerability. VC's office, I presume. A team of faculty and officers will deliberate on these logistics. Once the logistics are worked out, it will be implemented at places where there is a single entry to the unit, like the School of Life Sciences, the GARD, Computer and Information Sciences, etc. Police outpost, as per the mandate of the UGC, also needs to be actively deliberated upon. I don't know why do they need this when we already have so much police on the campus. To appoint an ombudsman and an anti-discriminatory officer to implement the guidelines of the UGC. Retired police officers, professors, lawyers, among others, should be a part of the committee. Registrar to talk to the deputy secretary concerned in MHRD on the above points. Okay, point 10. Unauthorized boarders staying in the hostel should be evicted by issuing a notice by the chief warden, as they are proving to be drain on the scarce resources of the university. The chief warden will initiate the process as per the guidelines available in the hostel handbook. It was decided that the unauthorized things accumulated at shopping complex will have to be removed. The registrar and the DSW will prepare an action plan and seek the support of police if required. The action will start after giving notice to the concerned. A circular should be issued by the university firmly stating that nobody should use the space of the university for installing statues, busts or other unauthorized structures. The committee was constituted to negotiate with the agitating students in order to restore normalcy on the campus. This committee would discuss with the student representatives the matters that are negotiable from the list of demands submitted by them to the university. The committee consisted of 7 professors from different schools, and the committee would inform the JAC and the students union to nominate 2 members each before starting the dialogue process to break the existing impasse. The report in this regard needs to be submitted within 6 weeks from the date of issue of the notification. The report shall be made public after its due consideration by the committee. The last point, the sukoon for the current academic year will be permitted as per the request given by the Students' Union, that is 7th of April 2016. Which was given earlier. And Students' Union, we've already seen in at least Facebook that the Students' Union president has put up a status saying that we do not want any sort of negotiation with this team. We are not interested in any kind of negotiation with anybody coming from the administration until and unless Appa Rao is sacked, Appa Rao is arrested. Another is, I would now start Eklavya Speaks with...